Okay, group one, this is your pick a card. So, how can you connect better with your partner? I feel like there need to be a break, but in a way that there can be some type of understanding. Because I feel like with this Three of Swords, that there's been a lot of heartache, like some deep, painful wounds that are fresh. So there needs to be some peace, and you have to go ahead and do it. It doesn't mean that you have to accept what they did or how they treated you, but you could refuse to fight with them anymore. And don't fight with yourself. If you love this person and you still love them, go ahead and acknowledge that and admit that. If you have to tell them, then tell them. But don't tell them with an expectation of them loving you back. Don't tell them with any expectations. Do it for yourself and your own healing. You have to create peace in this situation. I feel like the person that you're dealing with, they're just too immature. They're too immature with this Page of Cups reverse. Let me read this damn card. Signifies a male under 30, cool, unemotional nature, a sensuous person who stresses the physical side of life, worldly and jaded. Life holds no surprises for this person. Attractive and well-dressed, he might deceive you and is not as he appears. Do not trust this man with your heart. He will break it. That's the energy that they're in right now. You don't have to, this person can be a woman, so don't get caught up in genders, but that's the energy that they in. They too immature. So I think that it'll be wise if you like create some space from this person right now. But do it in peace. Don't fight with them. Don't play no games. You play games, it's gonna hurt you. Okay? Don't play no games. Let your heart feel whatever it feels. Let it feel that. It's okay to feel it, but you have a choice. You don't have to accept nothing that you don't want, but you could do it in peace. You can't make nobody do what you want them to do. They have to have it within themselves already to want to treat you that way. So, do what you need to do for your healing. And playing games and all of that is not going to help. Oh, I'm going to get some clarity on this. Okay, so man, I had to remove some clothes and get super comfortable. Because this Mercury retrograde got me feeling so intense. Dog. Anyways, that's why I'm gonna work on being chill. Being chill. Okay. All right, so you really love this person. I understand. This person has your heart, like for real. Really love this person. But this person may be spreading rumors about you. Conveys information only for personal gain. Spreads fear and falsehood. So this person could be talking about you in a negative way, saying some really bad things, something that very hurtful. And they just can't make up their mind about you. And I feel like the attachment with this devil card, it just feels like it's codependent, it's unhealthy. Like, I really feel like right now this person cannot be what you need. They just can't. Like how they are right now, they will just only hurt you. And I feel like with this lover's cards, I feel like you feel deeply connected with this person. And then underneath this, when I post this on my YouTube, I will post the pictures. I got the thief card, and in this card, this person opened up their jacket and it's a heart in it. So this person has your heart, so it's hard for you to move on from them, but they just can't be what you need right now. Now, I feel like in the future, somebody, and this is somebody from the past, and this person was immature in the past. These damn cycles. But they want to come back and give it another chance, and they different now. They did some growing up. I do feel like they're pretty young. And this is going to work out good. But I do feel like you have to let go of this person first. I also feel like for some people, this could also be this person maturing in the future. And maybe having something better to offer. But I feel like for most people, this is somebody else from your past. And you may already know who this is. Like maybe you've spoken to them or maybe they send you a friend request or something. But I think that things will turn out good with this person. You will have to take some time and heal. Because I feel like you have some unhealthy ways of viewing relationships. Like you're not really seeing your worth. And sometimes you could have a victim mentality or make people feel like they have to rescue you. But you have to realize your own power. You have to realize it and really believe in it and stand in it and utilize it. So, before you start anything else, make sure you work on yourself first so that you can have a healthy relationship with somebody. So, under this Three of Swords, I got this Queen card. So, I feel like I was gonna say like potential, but I feel like it's more than that. I feel like there's a lot of reasons why you should feel good about yourself. Like, you're a beautiful person inside and out. So, you have to really understand what that means. I'm gonna pull some clarity for it. I just feel like a lot of people in your past made you feel like you was less than. Made you feel like you should make yourself feel small. Like people who wanted to dim your light. And they really got inside of you and made you feel like you're not worthy of feeling like royalty. But child, you gotta get over that. Come on now. You got to get over that. There's no reason. You could do better. I feel like you're a person that has a lot going on for yourself. You're smart. You got a beautiful heart. So, there's no reason for you to feel bad about yourself. And don't allow anybody to make you feel like that. Like, you got power over that. You got power over what somebody say to you and how you allowed to make that feel. Like, they could call you out your name. They could say whatever. But you know what? I feel like this person, though, this person that you need to let go, I feel like, because this is the Page of Cups, so that's that emotional manipulation right there. So this person really knew how to get into your emotions and make you feel a ways. Yeah, I feel like this person could have been narcissistic, like gaslighting you a lot. I feel like there was a lot of emotional manipulation. So you have to let this person go And there is something better that wants to come towards you. Much better. Much better. For real. All right, I'm gonna get some advice from spirit for you with this goddess guidance oracle card. Dog, come on, box. Okay, so I do feel like you need to allow change to happen by releasing the burden, releasing whatever don't make you feel good. You don't have to, I mean, you could do everything in a positive way if you really put in the effort. You could do everything in a way that it would create healing so it won't hurt you later. And I feel like you coming into a lot of changes, like you going through a transformation. And you completing some cycles. Because this relationship with this Page of Cups, the ending of this, like you learned a lot from it. You learned a lot from it about yourself. So the ending of it is completing a cycle. And then somebody from your past wants to come back in your life and treat you right. That's like so karmic to me. So, in a beautiful way, not in a negative way. Also, the universe is saying don't worry about anything. Like, you do have to work on peace of mind and having peace within yourself. Like, be gentle with yourself. Be compassionate with yourself. Love on yourself. So, with this cycles and rhythms card, I feel like this is like tied into the transformation and the cycles that you are completing. That's a confirmation. Like, you are completing a lot of cycles. And I do feel like you've been putting in the work. I feel like you've been really working on being a better version of yourself. And it's a blessing in that. So then I got this past life card because I feel like the person that you are dealing with now and the person that wants to come back is both from your past life. It is a past life connection. That's why you feel so strongly about it. And I don't really want to get into like this is like a karmic relationship. Because the way I see it is that like all relationships are karmic. All of them. They all have some type of attachment, some type of baggage, and we just have choices of how we could deal with it. And if that's what we want, like you decide, this person is coming to you, presenting you with an opportunity. So you have to look at that opportunity and figure out, will this make me happy? What they offering me? Is this enough for me? Is this something that will hurt me or make me doubt myself? And either you could take it or leave it. But if you're trying to change it and control it, that ain't gonna work out well for you. It's just gonna hurt. So don't do that. Don't do that to yourself. I'm telling you, it's just gonna hurt. And then you're gonna get tired. And then guess what? Either you're gonna stay with this person and have them treat you however they're gonna treat you, or you let it go. It doesn't mean that it won't come back, but only allow it to come back if it's willing to offer you what you want. Okay? So that is your reading. I'm gonna end it right here and stay blessed. Okay, group two, this is your pick a card reading, and this is a reading on how can you connect better with your partner. So starting out, group two is very similar to group one. The difference is, though, I feel like with this group, you and your partner, I feel like have a good chance of making things work and figuring things out and coming in harmony with each other. More so in group one, it was more about pretty much moving on from that person so that another partnership can come in, or moving on from that person so they can get their stuff together and come back as a better partner. But either way, they have to let it go. But I do feel like you may be suffering in silence. There is a need to like take a step back, take a break from this, and go into introspection with this rest and rejuvenation card. And I got a new card deck today. I really it's the Psychic Tarot Oracle deck. I'm already loving them. This might be like one of my new favorites. All right. So I pulled some clarity for that, and the clarity I pulled was solitude and awareness. Introspection. You have to take some time, pull away from this, and really focus on yourself. Because I feel like you may be in survival mode right now with this base chakra here. I feel like you going through a lot outside of this partnership, so and you need to handle those things so you can have more peace and harmony within this. But I do have a feeling of hopeful that this partnership right here will work out or come back together. But I do feel like both you and your partner have some shadow work to do. You also may be a person that is going through an awakening process, and those can be very hard. It could cause you to feel confused about the things that you want because you are outgrowing some things. You are outgrowing a lot. I can feel that. I feel like this relationship is affected by finances, financial problems. Maybe both of you are like in this survival mode. Maybe that's why some distance in the relationship because of financial issues. I did hear a marriage, so you may be married to this person. And financial issues is what's causing a need for like separation. So I got the throat chakra card. The bottom of the deck energy was suffering and silence. Let me take that card out. So I feel like you need to verbalize a lot of things that you want. You need to open up and talk and have a conversation. Because I'm feeling like you may not be telling this person like how you feel and about your concerns and stuff. Maybe it's because you feel like that is remaining strong, but in actuality, it really is hurting you, man. These gonna be my new favorite deck right here. I can already feel it. I'm loving this deck already. I'm fell in love. So, you need to express what you want. And when I said that, spirit's like you confused about what you want. So that's why you need to take this break and figure it out. Okay, clarity for this hope. Yeah, I do feel like optimistic feeling within this relationship on both sides from you and your partner. It may need to be some truth spoken. Yeah, I feel like you're gonna be forced into solitude. If you just don't take it yourself, the universe is gonna cause a situation where you're gonna be forced to deal with yourself. Because I'm feeling like there needs to be some alignments in your chakras. Also, I'm just getting a feeling like you're not feeling comfortable with expressing yourself, with showing how you truly feel. And with this hope card under it, I pull truth and authority. So I'm feeling like you're feeling optimistic about this partnership, this relationship. But you may be withholding like some truths to feel more in control. You may not be saying things, you may not be expressing yourself in ways to hold on to control. You're definitely going through a transformation. I'm seeing that in like multiple cards. Like you are going through some type of change. Something is really hitting you hard where it's forcing you to change. And you will have to go into solitude. And I don't think it's just with this partner here. I feel like in general, like you have to really go inside yourself and face your shadows. And then you may feel like if it's like a long-term relationship, maybe you feel like the thrill is gone. Maybe you feel like, maybe this just ain't gonna work out or whatever, but when you start to face your shadows, I do feel like it's going to awaken so much love inside of you towards this person. But it's like buried under your shadows, under everything that you're repressing. So I feel like you're repressing a lot. And the love that you have for this person is one of them, is one of the things that you are suppressing. So, maybe something had already happened where a tower moment has happened and you and this person had to separate just so this transformation can take place how it should without any interruption. And I feel like you already know this, like deep down inside of you, you already know that everything I'm saying, everything that I'm saying, you already know it. So this is like confirmation for you. So I'm gonna pull some cards on like, how is your partner feeling about you? Okay, so this person is in their feelings about you. They are emotional. There is love coming through this from their side. But I do feel like there is a separation right now because it's like I got the card, the waiting game. So it's like they waiting for you to decide or waiting on you to figure out what you really want. But they are optimistic as well. I feel this with this triumph and success card, like, yeah. So this is telling me that both you and this person are drawn to each other. Like there is a sense of commitment, even when y'all not together. There's a sense of like, this is my person. This is the person I love. This is the person I'm supposed to be with. But both of you are like going through a transformation. And y'all might have to do this transformation separately. Yeah, this person feels a lot for you. Like, you really activate their heart chakra. And I feel like they optimistic too. They optimistic about this relationship. It's just like they just waiting. I feel like they trying to give you the space that you need to figure things out. But they love you. They do. They love you deeply. Like with this passion ignited, it is like a passionate, fiery type love, but it's genuine. And I could tell it's genuine because they are giving you the space that you need. They're not being selfish with your time. I'm gonna have to cut on this fan. They do feel like the strain of the separation. With this discontent and boredom card, I just feel like they may be, what's the word? Like they have all these feelings for you, deep, deep feelings, but I feel like they've been waiting on you for a minute. Or they have just been waiting for things to get better. And during right now, their energy right now, they feel discontent. They feeling bored without you. They feeling this separation. And if y'all not separated yet, then I do feel like a moment, a Tara moment is gonna cause y'all to separate. For momentarily though, I really do feel like it's momentarily, 'cause I do feel like you and this person are supposed to be together in the most beautiful way too. I pull destiny and harmony. So it's something beautiful here. It's just like y'all can't reach it because, for one, y'all are going through a transformation, a deeply spiritual one, that I feel like gonna make both of you better partners. And y'all both feel this connection. I feel like you two can have something beautiful together, something that y'all really comfortable with each other, can truly express yourself how you want to express yourself. Y'all can really find some happiness within each other. But I feel like right now is just not the time, because there's a lot of work that need to be done. Now let me tell you all the chakra cards I pull. Base chakra, solar plexus, throat chakra, and heart chakra. So if I was you, I would look that up. And I will look that up and find ways to work on those chakras. So that's the heart, throat, solar plexus, and base chakra. Because that's what the universe is trying to bring into balance right now. So when y'all do get together, I feel like it's something powerful about this connection. So when y'all get together, it's like y'all gonna create success together. Yeah. Once the healing is done and everything, there's gonna be something very powerful about this connection. Like, y'all gonna do great things together. And look, I don't feel like you should wait on nobody. You don't have to dedicate your life to nobody and nothing like that. But I do. This feels like meant to be energy. Like, for this lifetime, y'all gonna spend this lifetime together. I mean, if you do the work, and that's something like Spirit just said, that like the work has to be done first. In order for this type of love to exist, and in order for it to exist in harmony, like the work has to be done first. It just has to be. Okay, ooh, I'm running long, y'all. I'm running long. Sorry. So I'm gonna get you some advice on what you can do within this relationship. I'm using my goddess guidance oracle cards. Don't get caught up in genders, y'all. Don't get caught up in genders. Everything is energy. Everything. Okay, so the advice that I got for group two is that Trust your intuition. I got the High Priestess card. It says you have divine knowledge that can help others through spiritual teaching. I feel like this is what the universe is preparing you for. And I feel like this person is tied into your destiny, into your purpose. But if they're not treating you right, know that you don't have to deal with that. But I don't really get that. I don't get that energy. I also got past life connection. So this person and you had many lifetimes together. I feel like y'all have a strong spiritual connection and that y'all have contracted to be together in this lifetime. And I feel like y'all have like a high purpose to help other people, to help humanity to heal. But, you know, first you have to heal yourself. The universe is also saying that they're going to make things right. So if you feel like anything was like unfair in this relationship, the universe is going to come in and make it right. So don't worry about anything. This situation will be handled in a fair and just manner. And spirit means that. So I wouldn't worry about like I feel like this person that you're dealing with, that you're asking about, they are very understanding. I feel like they know deep down inside what this connection is. So if you need to like take time or whatever to really think about it, I feel like this person will be respectful, but they have a lot of strong feelings for you. And I feel like they will definitely miss you in your absence. Also, I feel like there's a practice that I do. I'm getting it from this Bodies of Water card. It says spend time near water, such as a lake, river, or the ocean, to recharge your batteries. So I think that would be healing for you. But also, when I'm taking a shower, I have this meditation that when the water is running down your body, you saying what you want to release. Like, I want to release doubt. I want to release fear. I want to release negative attachments, stuff that no longer serve me. And as the water is running down your body, you visualize it cleansing you of that energy, and it's going down the drain. I feel like that's something that would be good for you. Also, I got bold. Unleash your adventurous side, take risks, and be daring. Yeah, because I feel like you keep yourself very bondage up. I don't think that you're comfortable with being vulnerable. You're not comfortable with like truly expressing like deep emotional feelings, because maybe you feel like that takes away control. But nah, it's actually power in that, because you are speaking your truth and you are also not holding on to things. It will make your spirit lighter to express yourself and to speak your truth to people that you trust. Close friends and family, people that you trust. This person, I feel like if you talk to them and told them how you feel, they will understand, because they do love you, and they love you in a divine way. So under the deck, I got undying love. The love you have shared is eternal, regardless of the situation. So it's saying that this love that you and this person have between you is unconditional. It's unconditional. So, and that's beautiful. Well, I'm gonna wrap up the reading right here. Stay blessed. And yeah, like, comment, share. I can't believe. Hey, Crew 3, this is your pick a card reading. This is on how you can better connect with your partner. So, already starting out, this is already feeling similar, very similar to Group 2, and just a little bit similar to Group 1. All three groups started out, like the first card I pulled out was talking about taking time to rejuvenate, withdrawing, introspection. It's like that Mercury retrograde energy. Right now it's a good time to go within yourself and work on yourself. So, all right. So, with you and this person, I feel like, similar to Group 2, that you and this person are destined to be together. Y'all have a very powerful union, a very powerful connection. There's a lot of love here, a lot of love. And there's also a lot of abundance here. I'm gonna get some clarity on this emotional withdrawal, because with everything going so good, why is a need to withdraw? I'm kind of feeling like you may be feeling slightly overwhelmed by this connection. Like, the feelings that you have for this person is really intense, and it makes you want to withdraw emotionally, because you just need to take some time to center yourself. I'm also getting this throat chakra here. So I feel like there is a need for some type of communication. Not just communication, but with this harmony card, I feel like there is a need for like some understanding. Like, I feel like there may have been some misunderstandings between you and your partner lately. And because of that, you're feeling like withdrawing emotionally. I feel like that, something had happened that made you feel like you have to take your energy from them, but you still feel deeply connected to them. But I don't feel like they was completely understanding you. I feel like there was a conversation or something like that, and there was a misunderstanding. And because of this misunderstanding, because I don't feel like it was like an argument per se, but it was a deep conversation. And maybe you walked away from it feeling like even more confused. Or feeling like you can't fully express yourself to this person at this time. Yeah, I feel like this person is just not emotionally fulfilling you right now. So you feeling like you have to take a step back. You actually feel like you have to move on from this situation. There has been some deception here, and it's causing you to feel like just confused. So you might have had communicated with this person, and you thought through communication that it was going to create harmony, but instead, it just made you feel like you have to move on. And you may also feel like this person is being a little bit deceptive, not telling you everything. And it's just like too much. It's too much to handle right now. It do feel like an emotional overload because I feel like you care about this person a lot. You really deep down truly care about this person. And you may even feel like this person is like your wish fulfillment, but they're not giving you what you need or what you deserve out of this relationship. And there's a lot that you know, because I'm getting this third eye chakra. It's like you know a lot about the reason or purpose of this relationship. Maybe you have watched other pick a card readings, or maybe you do your own readings or whatever, because I do feel like you're very intuitive. But you know about this connection on a deeper level, but this person is not on the same page. So you feeling like moving away, moving along. Yeah, it's like on the surface, it's like this top row of cards. I'm gonna post this on my podcast, but on my YouTube, I will be posting a video with actual pictures where y'all can see the cards. But on the top row, we have emotional withdrawal, destiny, heart chakra, love begins, and fertility, which in this deck is the Empress card. So underneath the surface, it's a lot of love. Well, not underneath, but on the surface. Like there was a lot of love expressed. But underneath that is issues, deception, conflict, being confused. I feel like a energy of confusion. Like you want to love this person. You want to connect with this person, but you just feel like y'all speaking two different languages. So even though you have all this love, like I have this love card, and it's like the love is just pouring down into this river. But when you look at the cards under this, I got obstacles and challenges, suffering and silence. So even though you have all this love, it's like this situation is too toxic to invest in right now. Like right now, it's a good time to work on yourself and work on creating abundance for yourself with this material harvest. I feel like you are about to shift your thinking into maybe business or earthly things like paying your bills or whatever. Or I do feel like you're also going to be blessed financially. So under this Empress card, I got passion ignited. So yeah, you have a lot of love for this person, a lot. It's just that the environment, you can't really express that right now. It's like you feel like you have to move on right now. Yeah, there is some healing. Like, okay, I feel like this is, you have a knowing and understanding, intuition. And it makes you feel like you love this person, you have a lot of passion for you. You may even feel like you and this person are destined to be together, but you just cannot get on the same page. There's a lack of clear communication. No, not even clear communication. It's a lack of understanding. And there's somebody is not being 100% truthful. And you feel like you can't invest into this. Not right now, not how it is. You feel like you can't invest right now. All right, so I'm gonna get some cards of how this person feels about you. This person is also feeling like y'all need some time apart. They trying to figure out what's going on with them internally as well as you. There is some truth that needs to be spoken on their behalf, but I just don't feel like they in that space right now to give you that truth. Yeah, I'm feeling that strongly. They just not in that space. They are coming to some type of awareness. Like, they feel this connection, but it's just like I feel like this person felt like they can't help themselves. They can't help but handle things how they handle things. I feel like this person knows what you know about this connection. It's just that I'm gonna get some more clarity on that. So, all right, I think I'm starting to understand. Okay, so I do feel like this person have a like awareness of this connection, but they just don't feel like it's a good time. They are worried a lot about creating a strong foundation to even carry a love like this. So they kind of like just they taking a break and focusing on like achievements that they have for themselves. But yeah, and then under the truth card, I got the waiting game. So this person's they This is this do feels connected to group two. And then I got the hope card. So this person is hopeful. They feeling like one day y'all gonna come back together and build something. But at that point, because it's like a progression in these cards, at that point, they feel like they will have their stuff together. They will have a stronger foundation. And once they create that, they're gonna feel more open to this relationship. Okay, get some clarity on this solitude. Yeah, they really. You feel like you need to step away, and they feel like they need to step away too. Both of you feeling like right now y'all need to focus on yourself. Yeah, so with the Triumph card, they feel like they know that y'all could have something beautiful, something great. They just don't feel ready to take on this relationship. They just not in that space right now. It could be financial. I'm not sure if I mentioned that in group two or this one, but it's like you should watch group two too. Yeah, I feel like there are some financial things going on that needs to be taken care of, because I feel like this person you asking about, they care a lot about security. And providing security and stuff like that. So they just not, they don't feel secure right now, so they can't be open to love. Not this type of love. They just, but they are like conflicted about it. They feeling it. They feeling like the connection. They feeling the confusion. They feeling the need to tell the truth. They feeling conflicted about this relationship. It's like they feeling what you feeling, but I do feel like they are expressing themselves differently. So you may think like this person don't even care about you, but they do care. But right now their focus is on something else. It's on something else. It's on creating a strong foundation. And once they get secure financially, I feel like they would come back to you or try to open this door right now. They feel you walking away from them. So, but they are hopeful that when they do come back abundantly, when they do come back, they hopeful that you will open the door for them, that you will give them an opportunity, a chance. But they feel like there's a possibility that that might not happen. But they are willing to take that risk because they just don't feel ready right now. I do feel like they have a need to tell you how they feel, to tell you the truth. It's just that I feel like they're afraid that if they tell you how they feel, then it's going to, like, okay, they want to tell you like, I love you, I care about you, but right now I'm not in a good space. I have to, you know, get my money up and stuff like that, or I have to work on other relationships or situations. I just can't give you what you deserve right now. It's like they don't really want to tell you that because they don't want you waiting on them. Because they don't know how the future is going to be. They do want you to be happy, though. That's deep. That's deep. They do want you to be happy, but they just, right now, they can't provide you happiness. That's how they feel, regardless of like your perception of it. Because I feel like them withholding this love for you, withholding just truth, It's making you feel like they are deceptive. But they feeling like they doing the right thing. So, and I don't feel like this person wants you to wait on them. They want you to do what you gotta do for your own happiness. They don't want you to wait on them. So it's okay to like fall in love with somebody else, you know. Everything is divine. Like if this person come back and you in a relationship or whatever, they already thought about all of this. They already thought about all of that. Like I feel like it will hurt them, but they will understand. They will understand. I do feel like there's an undertone of them being afraid of losing you, but because like this destiny card right here, and they feel that too. They feel like this is destined too, so it just makes them optimistic, like you and this person, like they feel like nobody can take your place and nobody can take theirs. I mean, you could prove them wrong. You can prove them wrong. Do what you gotta do. Do what you gotta do for you. Don't sit here and wait on this person to get their act together. Because you don't know when that's gonna be. And during that time, if you are sitting still, waiting on this person. And let's say that a year down the line, they get their finances together, but they decide that, oh, I'm gonna be with somebody else. Then you're gonna be hurt. You're gonna be hurt that you didn't like, you put your life on hold. You put your life on pause because. And I kind of feel like you have a lot of love for this person. So it's almost like you feel like you can't do nothing but wait for them. Because you love this person. You feel like this destiny card. That's why, they feel like they're doing the right thing, but from just spiritual awareness, I don't feel like that's the right thing. A lot of that is due to their own fears, insecurities, and stuff like that. So in return, they're hurting you and they're hurting themselves. And it's not the way to do things, but this is how society make us think. They think that we have to do things like this. So, and that's another reason why it may be a good idea to move on, because I do feel this person's perception of things are different than yours. They more worldly and you are like more spiritual. So you may be like, you know, forget all of that. Like, let's just love each other. But this person puts a lot of value in materialism, money, security. They put a lot of value in that. So, and this could, and I feel like that's a lesson that they learning from the universe. Because with this moving on card, you feeling about done, and they gonna feel that. They gonna feel that. They already feeling it, But this could be like fresh, right? So they still feeling hopeful, but as time go on, it's gonna become heavier because this is destiny. This is like contracted. So yeah, they gonna feel it. And don't just move on for that reason. Don't just move on with the intent to have this person come after you. I don't feel like this is that type of person. I feel like their way of thinking and perceiving things, they really, it's like seeing like a lot of bondages on their soul. Like they are caught up in a lot of mental traps. So, and they very determined, very stubborn. So, I don't feel like that's gonna be the reaction. Don't do it for that. Move on for yourself. Do it for you. You will be much happier at the end of the day. All right, good three. So I got some advice from you from Spirit. And Spirit is saying that continue to believe in yourself and in your power to manifest anything that you want to manifest. Spirit is also saying that if things don't work out with this person, you will have divine love in your life, but you have to believe that. And you have to be open to that. Also, I feel like you are transitioning, like maybe even locational, like moving to a new home. This card says your home situation is improving, either through a move or a healthy change in the occupants. So things are moving around for you, and you are being push like on your path or push towards something that will make you happy. So you need to just go with the flow, don't try to resist it. Also, believe in your intuition. This person could have made you doubt your intuition, but the universe is saying that no. You, the high priestess, your intuition is on point. So, and it also saying don't worry about nothing. Don't worry about anything. Everything that is meant for you is gonna be that you're gonna receive that. Everything that's meant for you, you will receive it. So, find peace within yourself. Don't worry too much about this situation. You are doing the right thing. If you feel like you need to move on, then move on. And don't let anybody make you feel bad about that. Also, I feel like it's a good time to express yourself because I feel like this situation may have gave you a lot of inspiration, and you could channel that into your art. Whatever you do that is artistic, which is simply creating. If you like to play music, write lyrics, poetry, write a book, do what you need to do. But channel this energy into something positive, something abundant. So if you like, let's say that you're sure, like this is your person, this is the person you want to be with, and you don't really want to move on from them. Or maybe you was planning on moving on as in playing like some type of mind game or something. Like you saying you're moving on, but you're really not. Spirit is saying that, okay, whatever, but you need to take some space. You need some quiet time. Take some time alone to rest, meditate, and contemplate. So you do need space from this person. So regardless of the intentions, the reason, just make sure as you take in this space, you are working on yourself. You are manifesting for yourself. You are focused on yourself. Do not be overly focused on this person, because they focus on building their foundation. So yeah, they got feelings for you. They care about you. They think about you. But that's where their mind is at right now. It's not like on love. It's on building their foundation. So make sure that you are doing the same, because if this person do come back in your life, then y'all can be more on the same page. Get what I'm saying? So also, at the bottom of the deck, I got receptivity. Allow yourself to receive. This will increase your intuition, energy, and ability to give to others. Yeah, so I'm feeling like you may have gotten like other love offers, or just new experiences in general, but you might have been blocked off from it because how strongly you feel about this person. The universe is saying, no, you need to open up your heart a little bit so you could have new experiences and new opportunities, because don't attach all your wants, needs, and desires to this person. Make sure that you are open to all channels of love. So that's it, group three. I hope you enjoyed the reading. Please like, share, subscribe, and stay blessed.